The Great Granny block is inspired by the Great Granny square. I decided that I wanted to make one and use up my scraps and my fabrics, but I decided I wanted to use more scraps, and so I wanted to make my block bigger, which is why it became the Great Granny block. It was actually my grandma Yule, who was my dad's mother, who taught me how to crochet when I was six. I begged her to teach me, and that was the first thing that she taught me to crochet was the granny square. And she gave me scraps and leftover bits of her yarn, and I just crocheted and crocheted. This block really lends to be scrappy in all different color combinations. And I loved it because we just used the 2.5-inch squares, and there was just so many endless combinations. And especially with the additional row, each block uses four colors. I think one thing that you might like about my Great Granny Squared book is the simplicity of the block. And it allows you to play with color because it's just the same square over and over again in each block, but it's just the placement. And you really get to play with fabric, scale, print, and color. I like to see the difference in blocks when they finish a different size because they look completely different. Like the 6-inch from the 12-inch block almost looks like a completely different block, but the construction is exactly the same. Little blocks are really cute, and then I also like to make them giant size, so I used larger squares for the pillows. And then for my bonus quilt, I just used two of the rounds to make a smaller block, but it still finishes it a smaller size. I used 33 fat quarters so that I would have plenty of variety, and that's how I ended up with the bonus quilt, because I had enough squares left over that I could do a smaller variation of the block. Another thing that I hope you play with is the background color that you use for your blocks. Depending on what color combinations that you put together, you can really change the style. My grandma Crane taught me how to embroider. I asked her if she would teach me, and I begged her and begged her, and she thought I was too young, but she did teach me when I was six. And I just thought I was really grown up making those lazy daisy stitches. I taught my daughter Cassidy to embroider when she was about 7 years old. She does beautiful stitching now. She's 14 years old. And in fact, she did the stitching for me on both of the labels in the book. My labels that I chose to design for this book have kind of a crochet theme. It makes the quilt, the finished project, more important to the maker. It makes also the person, if you're giving it to someone, they realize that it was a gift of love, a work of art, and made from your heart and from your hands.